care if Monday's blue, Tuesday's clear, Wednesday too, Thursday, I don't care about you, it's Friday, I'm in love. One day you can fall apart, Tuesday, Wednesday, break my heart, Thursday doesn't even start, it's Friday, I'm in love.
We practiced that last night, and I almost cried. I almost lost it again, so. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Before we begin, on behalf of Justin and Jessica, I want to thank everyone for coming to the celebration today. I want to think about those people that can't be here with us today, so. Let's get going with this. All celebrations begin with the laughter, smiles, and applause. So, as uncomfortable as it may make them, I think we should start this out with everyone giving Justin and Jess a big round of applause. They didn't exactly want to be the center of attention, but I mean, come on, it is wedding. Today's a celebration. It's a celebration of love, of commitment, of friendship, of family, and of two people who are in it forever. You don't need to have a ceremony to have a marriage. We have thousands of important moments that happen throughout our lives, but this one's regarded as so critical. We acknowledge its special status by sharing it with others. So why this moment? Because despite all of our differences, love is what we all share. It's the great unifier, our one universal truth. That no matter who we are, where we've come from, or what we believe, we know this one thing: love is what we're doing right. That's why you both are standing here. That's why you all are here to watch them stand up and take these vows. We have all loved in our lifetimes, and in this moment, we're reminded that the ability to love is the very best part of our humanity. I hope you take time to pause and look back and smile at the moments that brought you here today. I hope everyone takes the time to dream and think about things that are to come. I'm here, we're all here, to hope with you, to support you, to be proud of you, and to remind you that love isn't always happily ever after. Love is the experience of writing your story. It's not one moment, not even this very moment. It's every moment. Big ones like saying I love you, or the first I love you. Moving in together, getting engaged. But mostly it's a million little ones that come in between the big ones. Falling asleep next to one another, making dinner together, spending holidays with your families, and getting a big hug when you get home from work. These everyday moments fuse together into one big experience.
So I get to share a reading with you, which is from a pastor who, among many other things, wrote the book Everything You Need to Know You Learned in Kindergarten. You've all read that book. You know Robert Foljam, who wrote that book. He wrote many books during his career, continues to, including one called From the Beginning to the End. And in that book, he talks about rituals in our life, including weddings. And he wrote a piece called Union, which Jess sent to me, and I fell in love with and thought this was a great thought for today. You have known each other from the first glance of acquaintance to this point of commitment. At some point, you decided to marry. From that moment of yes to this moment of yes, indeed, you have been making promises and agreements in an informal way. All those conversations that were held riding in a car or over a meal or during long walks, all those sentences that began with, when we're married, and continued with, I will, and you will, and we will. Those late night talks that included someday and somehow and maybe, and all those promises that are unspoken matters of the heart, all these common things and more are the real process of a wedding. The symbolic vows that you are about to make are a way of saying to one another, you know all those things we've promised and hoped and dreamed? Well, I meant it all, every word. Look at one another and remember this moment in time. Before this moment, you have been many things to one another: acquaintance, friend, companion, lover, dancing partner, and even teacher, for you have learned much from one another in these last few years, like how to drywall. Now you shall say a few words that take you across a threshold of life, and things will never quite be the same between you. For after these vows, you shall say to the world, this is my husband, this is my wife.
So giving away the bride is a very old tradition. It's usually significant to the father by giving the blessing or approving of the groom, family, or marriage. Sometimes it included cash. But with this celebration, it's not just a giving away that we should be concerned with. It's really the gaining of another person into your family. Sending them the love should be our true focus. Let's take a moment and acknowledge the parents of both the bride and the groom. Would the parents of the bride and groom please stand up? Justin and Jessica, your parents raised each of you and saw you through all of your firsts. Your first words, first day of school, first injury, first heartbreak, first success. So many firsts. With all these firsts, I think it's fitting to acknowledge your parents for the love, for letting them, and their love, for letting them be the first to accept and send love to you too. Debbie and Bob, will you send your love to Justin and Jessica and accept both of them with all of your love and support forever and ever and ever? Ed and Sharon, will you send your love to Jessica and Justin and accept both of them with all of your love and support forever and ever and ever?
We will.
Fantastic. The wedding vows. You fell in love by chance, but you're here today because you're making a choice. You're both choosing each other. You've chosen to be with someone who enhances you, who makes you think, who makes you smile, and makes every day brighter. You're about to make promises to each other that you intend to keep. You're going to take a vow to take care of each other, to stand up for one another, and to find happiness in the other. There's a simple premise to each of these promises. You're vowing to be there. You're teaming up and saying, to the other, every experience I am going to have, I want you to be a part of. Will you, Justin, keep Jessica as your favorite person to laugh with, go on adventures with, support through life's tough moments, be proud of her, grow old with her, and find new reasons to love her every day? Will you, Jessica, keep Justin as your favorite person to laugh with, go on adventures with, and to support through life's tough moments, be proud of him, grow old with him, and find new reasons to love him every day? Will you, Justin and Jessica, be each other's partners from this day forward? Will you bring out the best in one another? Share your happiest moments together? Love each other absolutely for the rest of this lifetime and for whatever may come next? Please exchange these rings. As you've both chosen to wear rings as a reminder of these promises that you just made. Love comes from humble beginnings, and through a combination of serendipity and effort, imperfect beings shape into something extraordinary. It's the process of making something beautiful where there was nothing at all. As you look at these rings over the years, I hope that you remember you've created something invaluable. And just as I know you will protect these rings, I'm confident that you'll protect these commitments you've made to one another today. I hope I haven't talked too long up here. Been pretty quick. Gotta get you some food here. Because this is a celebration and every celebration needs a toast, before we head into a delicious brunch, I'll ask you to all raise your glasses, but you don't have any, so that didn't quite work out as I planned. So let's just have a cheers in Norwegian. Skål.
Skål.
And I'd like to introduce Mr. and Mrs. Claydor, and you can high five and kiss and do whatever you want.
Teenage dream, I fucked it in my chest, so she knew.